Things are getting very, very complicated. The center can no longer hold. We are getting some information that Professor Kithure Kindiki will be sworn in tomorrow as the new deputy president. His swearing in will take place at Uhuru Gardens in Nairobi. And that's very interesting, because we have seen a court order stopping the implementations of the Senate resolutions that impeach Rigathi Gachagua. If William Ruto and his team proceeds with the swearing in, will they not be in contempt of the court order? Let's have a look at what Senior Counselor Amenasir Abdullahi is saying. Amenasir Abdullahi, senior counsel, appointment is what was stopped by Justice Chacha, and the appointment was made before the court order, not swearing in. So tomorrow's swearing ceremony can go ahead. I have blessed it. Senior counsel is saying that the High Court never stopped the swearing in, it only stopped the appointment. But by the time the order came, Professor Kithure Kindiki had already been appointed. So the court order was null and void. It had been overtaken by events. That's what senior counsel is saying. The most interesting bit about it, a president or a deputy president in Kenya can only be sworn in before the Chief Justice, or if the Chief Justice is absent, the deputy. So for the professor to be sworn in tomorrow, Martha Koome must be present. If Koome is not present, then Mwilu, her deputy. Will Koome attend that swearing in? Or will Mwilu attend that swearing in now that we are being told of a court order? Interesting times ahead. Let's have a look at what Moses Kura is saying as he gives us more information on the swearing in. Honorable Moses Kura, inspecting the site for tomorrow's swearing in of His Excellency Kithure Kindiki, third deputy president under the 2010 Katiba. Kura is a top government official and is confirming to Kenyans in broad daylight that Kithure Kindiki will be sworn in tomorrow. And Kura even went ahead to inspect the venue of the swearing in. Have a look at this.
Yes, my friend from Gatundu. You know you are my neighbor. Uko salama? Mungu ni mwema. Wow.
Professor
na nitakuwa live
Abraham.
Na nitakuwa live pia
bado wa MC itakuwa mmoja wao.
Asante.
So Kuria is confirming that Professor Kithure Kindiki will be sworn in tomorrow. Will Martha Koome be there? Or even her deputy? The swearing in of the deputy president elect shall be before the Chief Justice, or in the absence of the Chief Justice, the Deputy Chief Justice, and in public. He must be sworn in public. He can't be sworn in private. It has to be a public place in the presence of the Chief Justice or the Deputy Chief Justice. So we are waiting to see very interesting things come tomorrow. But I want us to put all this into perspective for Kenyans to understand the high octane politics being played here. Because something tells me very strongly, regard this up to something. What's happening here, ladies and gentlemen? Let's dig deep. What's regarding Gachagua's game plans here? I'm asking that question because I know, and maybe by now Rigathi also knows, he can't work with William Ruto and his government. Rigathi cannot work with a government where almost all the government members of parliament don't want him. All top government officials don't want him. How is he going to work in that government? And we also know that Rigathi Gachagua's residences and offices, all those are under the control of William Ruto's government. Ruto can decide to lock those doors or to chase him away. Rigathi Gachagua will do nothing. William Ruto can decide to withdraw Rigathi Gachagua's security, and Rigathi can do nothing. And goons can also be unleashed on him, something similar to what we saw at Uhuru Kenyatta's Northlands farm. So Rigathi cannot force himself to be in Ruto's government. Ruto controls almost everything. And Rigathi's life can be too difficult to a point he won't even be able to step in his office or in his official residences. Life can be made very difficult for him. So Rigathi can't force himself to work in Ruto's government. But I'm seeing a Rigathi Gachagua who is aiming for a long contracted legal battle for him eventually to resign, having served 2.5 years. Because according to the constitution, if Rigathi serves 2.5 years, then he'll get all the benefits. It will be construed to mean he has served a full term and he'll get all the benefits. That's Rigathi's first strategy. I'm seeing a person who wants a long contracted legal battles in the courts for him at least to serve 2.5 years. As it is right now, Rigathi has served about 2 years and 1 month. So 5 more months to go. If he can have a long contracted legal battles in courts for the next 5 months, and then he resigns, he'll have achieved what he wants. He'll get all the benefits. I'm also seeing a Rigathi Gachagua who is trying to force a deal with Ruto. Some times back, we were told that Rigathi approached Ruto and demanded that for him to resign, he must be given 8 billion Kenya shillings. It might still be the case that Rigathi does not want just to go that way. He wants to be given something by Ruto. So he's using the courts in order to force a deal with William Ruto, for William Ruto to pay him something. That's also something I'm seeing with Rigathi Gachagua. I'm also seeing a Rigathi Gachagua who is just politically naive. He still thinks that he can win this war. He can remain Kenya's deputy president. I'm also seeing a Rigathi who is thinking along that line. But then again, that's a very naive kind of a thinking or a line of thought. As it is right now, eventually, after all will have been said and done, even the courts will not save Rigathi Gachagua. So he's just wasting his money and wasting his time. He can't win this. The National Assembly impeached him. The Senate just affirmed that. All odds are stuck against Rigathi Gachagua. I believe those are some of the main reasons why Rigathi is still reluctant to let go. As I conclude, looking at what happened today, we saw celebrations in Mount Kenya East. On the part of Mount Kenya West, as much as they never came out strongly to oppose Kithure's appointment, there were some jitters. The jitters in Mount Kenya West and the celebrations in Mount Kenya East confirms William Ruto has succeeded in splitting the mountain vote. As things stand right now, Mount Kenya East will go with Kithure and William Samoei Ruto. And I've also maintained here that Ruto is not interested in the entire mountain vote. He just wants a section of the mountain vote and already has gotten it. Ruto has gotten Mount Kenya East votes. And if you look at it again, the war that was going on today, it came out clearly that Mount Kenya West and East were fighting. Rigathi was fighting Professor Kithure Kindiki. Rigathi is on record saying he cannot fight a brother again. Why can he not let Professor Kithure Kindiki be sworn in peacefully? Why is he fighting his swearing in? Politics is still getting interesting. Let me stop it there for now. If you are watching us but you have not yet subscribed, subscribe, give the video a like. Any person watching us outside Kenya, drop a comment, let us know from which part of the globe you are watching us from. If possible, subscribe, give the video a like. Stay tuned for our next analysis. Thank you.